हेलो एंड वेलकम किड्स, वंस अगेन टू योर मैथ्स क्लासेस ऑफ ग्रेड 5th. एज वी आर कॉन्टिन्यूइंग आवर सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ मैथ्स कोर्स बुक, दैट इज फोर फंडामेंटल प्रॉपर्टीज. सो दिस इज पार्ट थर्ड वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. एज यू कैन सी ओवर हियर, आई हैव रिटन डी एम ए एस रूल. इट इज कॉल्ड डमास रूल. इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो we have seen, let me once revise you, about four fundamental operations, addition and subtraction, that we have already seen in our previous video. Some addition and subtraction fact, like when we add zero or subtract zero from any number, then the result is the number itself. And then how Neha and her dad, they were purchasing some electronic gadgets. So how Neha calculated the total amount. And at last, when the shopkeeper made an offer that if they will pay rupees 1,60,000, then they will get the washing machine, refrigerator, oven, and a pair of speakers also. Then we have to find out the price of speaker. So from the total amount, that is 1,60,000, we have subtracted the price of the washing machine, refrigerator and oven, total price of those three items, and we get the price of speakers. And then we have learnt that how we will check our subtraction with addition. So whatever result has come after subtraction, whatever the sum has come, whatever the result has come, if we will add this much to this addend, and if we get the total 1,60,000 value, then our subtraction was okay, correct. So this we have studied, and then there were some exercises which I have given you. Some word problems were there. Regarding word problems, I have told you that you will have to understand. Okay, the word problem I think I have not given you, that we will discuss later on. Okay, only this much problem I have given you to solve. That was your homework. This section of the homework we will discuss on later on, okay? Then I have taught you about multiplication and division, that when a number is multiplied or divided by one, the result is the number itself, as you can see here in this example, okay? And when a number is multiplied by zero, the answer is always zero. When zero is divided by any number except zero, the answer is always zero, and division by zero is meaningless. So as you can see over here, then every multiplication fact has two division facts. Say 15 into 2, it will give us 30. So this 30, it has got two division facts. One is 15, one is 2. Okay. And then we have learned how to multiply. Okay. As it was the number and it has to be multiplied with 23, then we have to start from the ones I have taught you. And then when the ones place multiplication is finished, then we have to move on to the tens place. But first we have to put a zero at the ones place, and then we have to do the multiplication with the tens digit to this complete number. And at last we have to add it up. Okay. Again, this was the, here it is, three digit number with which we are going to multiply 17,940. So again, the same rule was followed. First, we have started from the ones place. First, we multiplied this complete number with 2. Then we moved on to the tens place digit for multiplication. But first, we have put 0 to the ones place. And then we multiplied this tens place to this complete number in the second row. And then we moved to the hundred place digit. That was 4. But first, we have put 0 to the ones place and to the tens place. And then we move forward. Okay, so remember, whenever we multiply a number by 10, 100, 1,000, write 1, 2, 3 and like that zeros respectively at the end of the product. Okay, so regarding the product, regarding the multiplication, this was your homework. Okay, so that was the multiplication. एंड दिस वेयर सम सम्स बेस्ड ऑन मल्टीप्लीकेशन विच आई हैव गिवन यू एज होमवर्क विच आई होप यू मस्ट हैव डन. ओके सो टॉकिंग अबाउट टूडेज टॉपिक दैट इज द सब टॉपिक दैट वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी. सो हियर डी स्टैंड फॉर डिविजन, इट इज द साइन ऑफ डिविजन. एम स्टैंड फॉर मल्टीप्लीकेशन, by writing a cross this is the sign of multiplication, you can call it x or cross also. A for addition, plus is the sign, and s for subtraction, the sign is minus. Okay, I think you all are already familiar with these signs and with these letters, what does they mean in mathematics. Okay, so the rule, the Damas rule says that when all four operations are given in one sum, we should first divide D, comma, then multiply M, then add A, and lastly subtract S. Let's see an example. So the Damas rule, it states that whenever you come across a question like this one, in which you have to solve or you have to do all these four fundamental operations which we have studied, which we have learnt, like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, then we have to move with this rule. First we have to attempt the division part, then we have to attempt the multiplication part, then we have to solve the addition part, and at the very last we have to do the subtraction part. So that is the Damas rule. Okay, you always have to keep this Damas rule in your mind while solving such questions where it is asking you to do all these four fundamental operations. Okay, we have to move, first we have to solve the division portion. Okay, then we have to solve the multiplication portion, then we have to solve the addition portion, and at the very last we will solve the subtraction part of that compounded question. Understood? And one more thing which I would like to tell you today, that how do we do division, how numbers are divided in mathematics. For example, as you can see over here, it is written divide ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh. Divide 6,70,584 by 213 and check your answer. So now see, there are certain terms in division which you have to keep in your mind, which you must know. The divisor, which is called a divisor, this is called a divisor. Okay, it is a divisor, and then it is written like this. Okay, we have to write it like this, and this is called the dividend. This number, the number by which we are dividing this big number, so this number is known as divisor, and the big number which is being divided, that is called dividend. This is called the quotient, and at last what is remaining, that is called the remainder. So all these terms should be clear in your mind, that which is called the divisor, which is called the dividend, which is called the quotient, and which is called the remainder. Sometimes questions comes in this form also. Okay, so now let's see. As you can see, with this 3-digit number, we have to divide this 6,70,584. So it is written that the divisor contains 3 digits. So we should consider 3 digits of the dividend, that is 670. Yes, this is the rule. If the divisor, it is containing 3 digits, then out of the dividend, we have to consider, first we have to consider the 3 digits. We will take 3 digits. So if we see what is the 3 digits, they are 670. Now we have to read the tables of this. But to read the table of 213, it's not very easy. So now we have to give a trial quotient. Okay, we have to find out a number near to the 670, which will come in the table of 213. So that is called the trial quotient. सो द ट्रायल कोशेंट इज थ्री. ओके सो द ट्रायल कोशेंट इज थ्री. तो दैट ट्रायल कोशेंट इट विल बी रिटन ओवर हियर एज यू कैन सी द ट्रायल कोशेंट इट इज थ्री. सो थ्री इज रिटन ओवर हियर. नाउ दिस थ्री इट विल गेट मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 213. सो थ्री थ्री ज़ा नाइन, थ्री वन ज़ा थ्री, थ्री टू ज़ा सिक्स. नाउ दिस 639 इट इज नियर टू 670. नाउ यू थिंक इफ वी हैव टेकन ट्रायल कोशेंट फोर देन द नंबर विच वी वुड हैव गेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल फोर थ्री ज़ा ट्वेल्व, वन गेट कैरिड, फोर वन ज़ा फोर प्लस वन फाइव एंड फोर टू ज़ा 8, it would have become 852, and 852 is greater than 670. So we couldn't take the trial quotient 4. Okay, we have to take the trial quotient near about 670. Okay, near about 670. So the trial quotient is 3, and then we have written 639 over here, and now we have to subtract. Okay, now we have to subtract. So after subtracting 639 from 670, we have got 3 1 10. It became 10 minus 9 1, because we have taken carried over 1 from this 7, so it become 10 minus 9 1, it has become 6 minus 3 3, and 6 minus 6 0. So no need to write 0 over here. Now we have got 31. Now what is the next step? As you can see over here, the trial quotient is 3, but 3 into 213 gives us 639, which is less than 670. So we will take 3 as a quotient. That I have already explained you that why we have taken 3 as a trial quotient. Okay, because we have to find out the digit near about to 670. Okay, so that's why we have taken 3 as the trial quotient. Now we have done the subtraction. 639 from 670, and bring down the next digit 5. Yes, now these three digits we have considered earlier, 670, the three digits of the dividend we have considered. Now we have to bring this next digit, which is remaining, that is 5, over here. Now it becomes 315. Yes, now 213, 315. What do you think? What will be the trial quotient? I think 1 will be the trial quotient. Okay, because 3 1 ja 3, 1 1 ja 1, and 2 1 ja 2, 213. Suppose if we have done, if we have taken the trial quotient 2, then what will be the result? Let's see. 213 is the divisor, no? So 3 2 ja 6, 2 1 ja 2, 2 2 ja 4, 426. Now 426 and 315, which is greater? 426 is greater, so we couldn't take 2 as the trial quotient. We have to take 1 as the trial quotient. So that's what written over here. That 213 when multiplied by 1, then the result is 213. So that what written over here. Then again we have to do subtraction. Then 5 minus 3, 2. 1 minus 1, 0. 3 minus 2, 1. Now it is 102, 213. Now we cannot divide 102 from 213 by 213, because 102 is smaller. Okay, so we now bring the next digit down. Next digit is 8, so 8 written over here. So these are all the steps, all the processes which we have to follow, which we have to do while dividing. So that's why you have to keep these steps, you have to practice these steps properly, so that you could also do the division problems properly. Now this 8 written over here, now it this number has become 1028. Now, as you can see, the trial quotient, it is taken 4 over here. Now, this you have to think that what trial quotient you have to take, okay? That you have to little bit apply your mind, little bit apply your brain, okay? You have to find out the digit in the trial quotient which will bring over here, that digit which will be near to this one, okay? So, this time the trial quotient is 4. So 213 multiplied by 4. 4 3 is 12. 1 get carried over. 4 1 ja 4 plus 1 5. 4 2 ja 8. 852. What would have happened if we have taken trial quotient 5? So 5 3 is 15. 1 get carried over. 5 1 ja 5 plus 1 6. 5 2 ja 10. So 1065, 1028. So we couldn't take 1065. We couldn't take 5 as the trial quotient. We have to take 4 as the trial quotient. So that's why 4 written over here, and this 852, it's written over here. Again, we have to do subtraction. So after subtracting 8 minus 2, we got 6. From 2, we couldn't subtract 5. So we take 1 carry over from here because it is 0. It couldn't give carry over. So it becomes 12. So 12 minus 5, 7. Now it became 9. So 9 minus 8, 1. Now 176. Now only one digit is left over here, as you can see. So that we have put down here because 176, it cannot be divided by 213 as 213 is larger than 176. Now this 4 written over here. Now again, what we have to take the trial quotient? This time the trial quotient is 8. Okay, this time the trial quotient is 8. 213, 8. 8, 3 are 24, 2 get carried over. 8, 1 are 8 or 2, 10. 1 get carried over. 8, 2 are 10 or 1, 11. So 8, 2 are 16 plus 1, 17. Okay, so 1704 written over here. Okay, because 1704 is near about 1764. Now again, do the subtraction. 4 minus 4, 0. 6 minus 0, 6. 7 minus 7, 0. 1 minus 1, nothing. Now this one, now there is no dividend digit. As you can see, we have written down all the digits. So this 60, it is remaining now. So this is the remainder and it is denoted by R. This is the trial quotient. It is denoted by Q. This is the divisor. It is denoted by D. And this is the dividend. So it is also written by D. But you have to understand the difference between the dividend and the divisor. Okay, so this was the steps which we have to follow while doing division problems, division sums. Now coming back to the one more method you have to understand, that is the checking of your division. So how the checking is done? So this is the formula which you have to keep in your mind, that quotient into divisor plus remainder, it should give you the dividend. Quotient into divisor plus remainder should give you the dividend. If this, after doing this, you get the dividend, then your division is correct. Okay, so as you can see over here, what is the quotient? What is our trial quotients? So these are trial quotients, 3148. So it is written over here, 3148. Okay, now according to the formula, we have to multiply the quotient with the divisor. We have to multiply the quotient with the divisor. So what is the divisor? It is 213. So 3148 multiplied by the divisor 213 plus remainder. What is the remainder? What remainder we have got? It is 60. So 60 written over here. Now as per the Damas rule, division is not there, multiplication. First, we will multiply 3148 and 213. First, 3148 and 213 is to be multiplied. As I have taught you multiplication earlier, how we are going to do the multiplication. So, that is your job. You will do. So, after multiplying, this is the result. That is 67,524. Now, to this, we have to add 60. We have to add remainder also, 60. So after adding 60, we have got this one, 67,584. So 67,584. Do we have got our dividend? Let's check. 67,500. Yes, we have got our dividend. So the result is matched with the dividend. So that's why it is written. Thus the answer is correct. Answer is correct means whatever division is being done over here, it is absolutely correct. So after doing your division sums, division problems, division questions, after solving that, you have to do the checking out also. You have to check out your division questions with this formula. What is the formula? It is quotient into divisor plus remainder. And after solving this section, it should match with the dividend. Whatever dividend is given in the question, your checking should match with that. Okay. Now there are some problems, as you can see. Exercise 2B. So I think it is a these questions are mix of division and product. So on in exercise 2B, only question number one, only question number one, this much and this much. I am giving you as homework exercise. Okay, so all these questions you have to do. Listen, kids, in maths, the more you will practice, the more perfect and the more accuracy you can achieve. Okay, now regarding the word problems, I will take another video session. I will give you, I will teach you how to read, how to take out the meaning in the word problems, and how to solve these word problems. Word problems means whatever question, those are given in a statement form. As you can see over here, there are statements written over here. So you have to understand the meaning of these statements, that what is being given, what is there to be given, and what is to be taken out, what is to be calculated, what is to be solved. Okay, so you have to derive the meaning of the question from these word problems. You have to understand the statement, what the question is asking, what the question is giving as a clue, as a hint. Okay, and these are simple problems in which direct questions is given, that you have to multiply 3087 into 24. Let's for your convenience, I am solving this first question. Okay, that as you can see, what is there? 3087, 3087, we have to multiply it with 24. Okay, never forget to put this sign. Now 4 sevens are 28, 2 will get carried over here. Now 4 eights are 32 plus 2, 34. We will write, out of 34 we will write 4 over here, and 3 will get carried over here to this place. Now 4 multiplied 0, 0, but 3 is there, so we will write down 3 over here. Okay, now 4 threes are 12. Now at ones place, what we have learned, we have to put 0 over here. We don't have to start calculation from here. Okay, for your convenience, you can write 1000, 100, tens, ones. Okay, you can write like this. Now we have to start multiplying from the tens place digit. 2 is remaining because with the 4 we have already, with the ones place 4 digit, we have already multiplied this number. Now put 0 over here. Now start multiplying with the tens digit. So 2 sevens are 14. 1 get carried over here to this 8. 8 to just 16 plus 1, 17. 7 written over here. 1 get carried over again to this point, to the 0. So 2 zeros are 0, but 1 will be written over here. And 2 threes are 6. Now what we have to do, we have to add these two addends. 8 plus 0, 8. 4 plus 4, 8. 3 plus 7, 10. So 3 plus 7, 10. 0 written over here. 1 get carried over here. So 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4, and 1 plus 6, 7. So this is the product. This is our answer. Okay. So one question I have solved for you. Rest you will attempt. So in this session of the video, this much only, because this division question was very important. This division concept is very important. So you just go through it, understand it, what it is saying, and just whatever division sums is given over here, like as you can see over here, question number E, question number G, okay, question number J. You should attempt these questions by yourself. And regarding the Dumas rule, I have already explained you what is Dumas rule, that in any given problem, in any given question, if all the operations are given, then how you have to move on? First, you have to attempt the division part of the question. Then after solving that, you have to attempt the multiplication part of the question. After attempting multiplication, you have to attempt the addition part of the question. And after attempting addition, at last you have to attempt the subtraction part of the question. Then the result which you will get, that will be the correct one. As you can see with this example, it is written solve 2154 plus 315 divided 5 multiplied 2 minus 101. So first, which part has been solved? The division part. These two are in division part. 315 divided by 5. So first that has been solved. Then whatever the result will come, this result has come out of this. This 63 you are seeing over here, this result has come when we have divided 315 by 5. Okay. So here you will write the trial quotient and you will keep on dividing. Okay. Here it is 5, here it is 3. So one, this digit, this dividend is smaller than 5. So we have to consider these two digits. So trial quotient will be 5, 6, 30. So after subtracting, we get 1. And now this 5, it will come down over here. Now read the table of 5. Do we get 15? Yes, 5, 3, 15. Remainder 0. So this will be come over here. Okay. And then multiply 2. Now we have to attempt the multiplication part of the question. So 2154 written as it is plus 63 into 2. 3 2s are 6 and 2 6s are 12. So it is written over here. Now which part we have to attempt? We have to attempt the addition part. So 2154 plus 126. 126 we have to add up. So 6 4 10. 6 plus 4 10 0. 1 get carried over. 5 or 2. 7 plus 1, 8, 1, 1, 2 and 2. So 2, 2, 8, 0, number minus 101. So after subtracting 1, 0, 1 from 2, 2, 8, 0, this will be the result. Okay. So this was all about today's session, today's class. Okay. Just go through the video carefully. Okay. And there are some questions based on Damas rule that I am also giving you as homework. So try to solve these questions by yourself for a better understanding. See you soon with the next part of this chapter video. Till then, take care and thank you for the class.